me something. Promise me you won't let me hear you pray. I promise you won't hear me. Get away from me, screw. What's your face?
It'll be the last face you see, big shot, and it'll be laughing at you.
Don't get near me now, I'll spit in your eye again.
Edward, stand back. Dalton, take care.
I don't need anybody, come on.
Shut up, boy, Rocky. Pick your own company.
So long, Rocky. We won't be long.
So long, Rocky.
What? You're just what?
I'm just trying to be honest with you, Dad. For maybe the first time in my life.
Honest? I read this filth in a letter, and you're trying to be honest?
That was my letter, Dad.
You want to throw your life away on this scum, and you think that by telling me about it, you're being honest.
That was my letter.
You are my legacy, do you understand?
Yes, I do.
You say you're in love. I say you're sick. And I am not going to leave my fortune or my business for the benefit of some gold-digging scum who's no better than a whore.
Dad, please.
A whore! Now, you listen to me. You will give up this person, or you will receive nothing from me, not one penny, I swear to God.
Dad, no, listen.
I will give you until tomorrow to decide. Now get out of here. I have to go to work.
May I have my letter?
Get out!
Doing, Johnny? got heavy day tonight?
You're nuts, you know that? You're really nuts. Oh, Jesus!
You're gonna be rolling in dough now, ain't you? Huh? That's the... What the hell you need a fiancé for?
Without the stutter.
What?
Drop the stutter. Drop the stutter.
I thought it was pretty good.
I thought it stunk.
I didn't change any of the lines or anything, honestly. I just wanted to give him a little emotional depth.
You wanted to win an Academy Award.
Say, wait a minute.
And you're not even in a movie. That makes it tough.
Cash, that's not fair.
Please? I was an actor before I was a director. I wrote the book. Please.
I swear to God.
I know.
I was not trying to...
I know. Sit down, Michael. Sit down. Oh, Maggie, I'm sorry, honey. Wash that stuff out of your hair. You are just terrific.
Thanks.
Michael, you're a good... Would you put the knife down, please? I wouldn't have hired you if you weren't good. But sometimes, Michael, our minds play tricks on us, and we suddenly see our mother and Aunt Tilly and Cecil B. DeMille, and they're all sitting out there watching us, and they're just sitting there and weeping because what we're doing is so beautiful. Leave him alone, Michael. Just let him sit there. You're in Stamford, Connecticut, not Hollywood.
I thought I would...
I know what you thought! Will you shut up and listen to me? You can't not stutter for 55 minutes, and then all of a sudden you've got to stutter. Killers are not nervous wrecks when they kill. They're cool-headed. They've got this psychopathic juice that flows through their brains and makes them think that they're God. Maybe there's a sudden rush of excitement, but cool-headed. In other words, Michael...
Drop the stutter.
That's my boy! This guy's taking all my punchlines. You want to experiment? You want to fool around? Try things out? Go ahead. But don't be someone you're not. You got to stay true to your character, okay?
Yes, sir. Excuse me, Mr. Carter. It's almost 5:30.
Ah, I got to go. Thanks, Billy.
Yeah.
I got to kiss somebody's ass at exactly 6 o'clock sharp, and he doesn't like it if I'm late.
Why?
Why doesn't he like it if I'm late, or the first part?
The first part.
Because you might give us $50,000 for dressing rooms and a new lobby.
Holy mackerel.
I hate asking for money. It's not me.
Then how are you going to stay in character?
I guess I'll have to be a bad actor. Hey, maybe I'll use a stutter.
I don't want to hug him and kiss him and pretend. You understand what I'm saying?
Sid, listen to me, please. He is such a dear boy. You don't know how much love there is in him. He is so sensitive, and he is so...
Are you deaf, Katie? I already know that you're dumb, but are you deaf, too?
Oh, Sid, I don't know how I can go on working for you.
Well, you don't have to go on working for me.
For God's sake,
get out of here. Just get out of here.
Oh, Mr. Carter.
Oh, hello, Kate. I'm sorry I was held up a little bit. I hope I'm not too late. Is he still in?
No, yes. I'll tell him you're here. Mr. Carter is here, sir.
Well, get him in here.
Please, come in, Mr. Carter.
Thanks.
Come in, sit down. I don't want any more calls, Ms. Faxon, and put these in the safe. Sit down, for God's sake.
Will you be needing me any more this evening, Mr. Lassiter?
I'm paying you, aren't I?
Yes, sir.
Then you stay here till I'm done. Now get out of here and close the door. Clear something up for me, will you?
What's that?
Are you Mr. Carter or Mr. Cash or... What the hell is your name anyway? I hear everybody calling you Cash.
My name is Lawrence Carter. Cash is just a nickname.
Lawrence Carter? You don't look like a Carter.
What does a Carter look like?
More Gentile.
People tell me I'm very gentle.
Mm-hmm. Lawrence Carter. I don't know, it smells a little fishy to me.
You know, you're very observant, Mr. Lassiter. My father's name was Kartofsky. They made him change it at immigration.
And they were right. Now you can get into all the better places. You know what I mean? Restaurants, country clubs, really elegant places that I know you would appreciate. Or they might not allow some of your more, what, pushy friends. I'm trying to be tactful here. You know what I'm saying?
Well, sure. As a matter of fact, there was a very influential man who said almost the same words to some of my friends just the other day.
Somebody I know?
No, he lives in Germany. Did you have a chance to look at the plans for the new lobby?
Yeah. If I give you this money, I want two things from you.
I'm listening.
I want a little bronze bust of me in the center of the lobby.
And the second thing?
You call it the Lassiter Theater. Or the Sydney Lassiter Theater. I don't know, whichever sounds classier.
It's the Stamford Repertory Theater.
If I give you $50,000, Mr. Carter, it's the Lassiter Theater. And I deserve it. I build locks, Mr. Carter. I design and make 27 different kinds of locks. And I make jobs for 920 people in this community. That's almost one out of every 16 people. I also make $1 million a year. What do you make?
I make locks, Mr. Lassiter. I make locks with cream cheese, locks with bagels, locks with onions, all kinds of locks.
So how come they call you Cash, anyway?
I directed 5 hits in a row on Broadway, and after the third one, some joker in Variety started calling me Cash and just caught
so
on.
So how come you quit New York and came to a little town like Stamford? You have a flop? You people have trouble with failure, don't you?
If I agree to your terms, Mr. Lassiter, I want two things from you.
My kind of guy. I'm listening.
No one, not even you, ever interferes with rehearsals or choice of plays or casting.
We'll see. What's the other thing?
Every time you come to the theater, and you have to promise me this, you'll paint a little Jewish star on your grotesque, anti-Semitic face. Fair?
Now listen to me.
You and your theater can rot in stinking hell, Mr. Kartofsky.
I wouldn't ask for a raise today, dear.
You still have your beautiful tan. I envy you.
You should sit outside and read instead of staying in your room all day.
Dr. Coburn says I mustn't get a chill.
Well, Coburn is an ass. It's supposed to be beautiful tomorrow. Do you good. Take advantage while we still have some nice days.
Will you be home late?
I don't know. I'm having dinner with Godlin.
Don't you have time for lawyers during the day? After dinner, will you be seeing one of your whores?
I don't see whores.
I'm sorry. Don't be angry. I envy you so. I just get frustrated. I'm so frustrated, Sid. Please don't be angry with me. I'm just jealous of them, Sidney. I want to make you happy the way they do.
You want to make me happy?
The way they do, yes. I could, you know. I could, Sidney, if you'd teach me. You have to show me all the things they do, and I'll learn them. Honestly, I will.
I find this embarrassing.
That's because you're a man. I'm not embarrassed.
Well, I'm embarrassed for you.
Take me with you.
Oh, you can't go out, you know that. You might get a chill.
me, please.
Martha, I yell like hell if anybody's ever late for a meeting. I can't start doing it myself.
Kiss me goodbye. I don't mean that kind of a kiss. How was that?
Wonderful. Don't wait up for me.
Please don't be late, Sydney.
Starting to rain again, Martha. Don't get a chill.
Goodbye, darling. Come in.
Sir Lester thought you might like a glass of sherry before dinner.
Just put it down.
Is there anything else I can do for you, Mrs. Lester?
No. Don't you have other matters to attend to?
To say this without seeming to be on the make.
Take a chance.
You're a damn good-looking girl, and you're smart, and believe it or not,